We were a self-defense group at first. We were a small group of maybe 30 men who was fed up with the tactics of the police. And so we started patrolling the police, making sure they didn't violate the rights of black citizens in the community with a law book and a gun.
This only means that black people reached the point where they're saying no more. No more. If you shoot me, I'm shooting back.
But through history, the historians have dissected that law book from our hands, and so that a lot of people see us, they just see the gun. But we used to cite the law to the police because they used to be violators of the law.
People always associate the Black Panthers with black power, black men with guns. It's all scary. They want to kill the white man. But the Black Panthers stated that you don't fight racism with racism, you fight racism with solidarity. The reason they're so scary to the state is because they weren't a group of black militants who wanted to kill white people. They wanted to just join the white people who were equally suppressed, because they understood that divide and rule is the way that all governments work. It happens now. Look at the EDL. Look at the way that that is rising. It's easier to set one tribe against another and say your problems are because they're stealing your jobs, they're stealing your houses, your social housing has been taken by the Polish, by the Romanians, by the Indians. That's not the way it works. We fight over the crumbs that they give us, and they keep us entrenched in slavery by having us fight among ourselves. And the Black Panther Party understood that, and they said, no, we're your brothers. Don't fight us, fight the systems. Fight the system that's only giving us crumbs. So they united the whites, the blacks, the Palestinians, the gay community. And that's what made them really, really scary, because they were educated and they understood how the systems of power work.
And in this sense, we say that not only are black people a vanguard, but they're an inspiration. We don't expect them to liberate us. We have to do that for ourselves. But they have inspired us to begin that struggle to end this imperialist, racist, colonial system once and for all.
We're trying to create a new type of brother in the community, an educated brother, who can go out and organize in the community and answer questions without stuttering and say, I don't know that.
To join the Black Panther Party, you had to read, I think it was 46 books, and you had to know them off by heart. And those books are like incredibly heavyweight books that explain socialism, Marxism. They have a real thorough understanding of politics, history, because it was a very academic approach to this idea of revolution.
Women in the Black Panther Party played a very important role. They were on security, had weapons, they led different programs, they taught political education class. I mean, their role was just as equal as important as brothers in the party. Now, because we had all these service to the people programs that were showing the contradictions between what the government was doing for the people and what we were doing, we was viciously attacked by the United States government.
Racist police agencies throughout the country are intensifying the terror, brutality, murder, and repression of black people.
J. Edgar Hoover had stated that the Black Panther Party was the biggest internal threat in the nation, and he vowed that he would, disrupt and dismantle the Black Panthers as an organization, and to destroy them, kill them, criminalize them. If they're not in prison, put them in prison, frame them. And if they were in prison, to keep them in prison, and he managed to do this.
We must not for a moment lose sight of our goal, to teach the criminal that regardless of his subterfuges, his squirming, his twisting and slimy wriggling, he cannot escape the one inexorable rule of law enforcement. You can't get away with it.
But what he did not manage to do was, and like Fred Hampton has said, you could kill a revolutionary, but you can't kill a revolution.
So we always say to the Black Panther Party that they can do anything they want to us. We might not be back. I might be in jail. I might be anywhere. But when I leave, you can remember I said with the last words on my lips that I am a revolutionary. And you're going to have to keep on saying that.
Absolutely stated they didn't want the rise of a black messiah. If you've been suppressing people and you've held them as slaves, imagine what kind of emotions is held up, and if you can light that.
My belief that Ronald Reagan is a punk, a sissy, and a coward, and I challenge him to a duel. I challenge the punk to a duel to the death, and he can choose his own weapons.
Our souls are battered and bruised, but we remain defiant. We have lost family members, friends, and comrades, but our spirits still soar. We, like all of you, at some time in our lives, made a conscious decision to become social revolutionaries. Our humanity would not allow us to close our eyes to the horrors waged against the poor, the homeless, the sick, the workers, and the artists of this country in the name of the great lie of American democracy.
We suffered a lot. Like I said, party members were killed, people went to jail, and we still have something like 15 party members in prison right now due to they were railroaded to jail. We have people in exile, like Asala Shakur, she's in Cuba, Pete O'Neill's in Tanzania. People still being affected by what happened 35 and 40 years ago.
Those they didn't shoot, they imprisoned, so loads of Black Panthers ended up being in prison. And so while they were in prison, they were able to spread their message. And they didn't mind being in prison because they said that they were in prison on the outside. It's the whole idea that, you know, it doesn't matter if you're locked in a cell or in your inside, you're a prisoner in your own mind unless you're truly free. But anyway, they imprisoned a lot of Black Panthers who met up with Robert King when he was 17 or Herman Wallace when he was 18. They met up with these young Black guys who had gone in for armed robbery, and they said to them, what is the crime of a bank robber compared to those that own the bank? They explained to them that they were there because of their own history and because of their own poverty, and there because their options were you go and shine shoes for Whitey or you go rob a bank.
The Negro is to be free. He must move down into the inner resources of his own soul and sign with a pen and ink of self-assertive manhood his own Emancipation Proclamation.
Prior to the abolition of slavery, about 95% of the people in prison were white. I say 95, more like 98%. That was because the logic behind that was the people who owned slaves saw them as commodity, a valuable piece of property that could be exploited and used and worked. And therefore, it would be unprofitable to put them in prison. So prison was not for a Black people. It was for the few whites who committed crime and they were held in prison. But now once slavery, chattel slavery ended, that trend reversed itself totally.
And the white power structure today is just as much interested in perpetuating slavery as the white power structure was 100 years ago. Only now they use modern methods of doing so.
The Black community is a smaller community, but our imprisonment rates are greater than any other group, as well as Mexican Americans. So they're using people today as modern slaves, you know? So you get sent into jail 30, 40 years, they get 30, 40 years of free labor from you.
A lot of people don't realize that in the 80s, a law was passed which allowed private corporations to come along and take over and build private prisons, which has meant that in the last 30 years, the prison population has actually increased by over 500%.
Truly disturbing new report from the Justice Policy Institute exposes just how depraved some privately owned prisons have become. They're apparently using campaign contributions, lobbying, and political relationships to actually increase prison populations. The report says, quote, over the years, these political strategies have allowed private prison companies to promote policies that lead to higher rates of incarceration and thus greater profit margins for their company. You better believe that's true. Since the year 2000, the number of people held in private federal facilities has increased about 120%. Now, you got to remember, at that same time period, the total number of people in prison increased only 16%. So it's a much bigger margin for those private prisons. Gee, I wonder how that happened. And it's all leading to big-time profits. In 2010, the two largest private prison companies, the Corrections Corporation of America, which sounds pretty scary, and the GEO Group, brought in over $2.9 billion in combined revenue. That's why they want more and more prisoners. And of course, the more money these corporations make, the more powerful they get. Since 2000, the three largest private prison companies have contributed over $6 million to local state politicians.
I found out that legality and morality is not the same, because Herman and Albert and Zulu, and me, a lot of members of the Black Panther Party, was legally confined, legally convicted, legally targeted by the FBI, legally prosecuted, legally placed in jail. Some are still in jail, but they are morally innocent of the crime.
In 1998, we actually went to Angola to visit Herman Wallace, Robert King, and Albert Woodfox. And since that time, we were only three members of the organization at that time. But today, in 2012, it's called the International Support Committee for the Angola 3. And as we sit in London right now, we have many supporters here. We have many supporters around the world. So the information about the Angola 3 has gotten out. And so what we are doing now are trying to put pressure on the judicial system in Louisiana to free them.
It was very disappointing to hand in a petition of 67,000 signatures earlier this year to the governor of that state and not to be able to meet with him, to be passed off to a lower official. I think that we need to ensure that we keep our efforts going, because I think it is only by wider knowledge of what is happening and wider condemnation that we can have some effect for both of these men. If you consider that Juan Mendez, the UN Special Rapporteur on Torture, has raised this case with the American authorities, then you can realise how shocking it is that the US ignores the UN and all those involved in the UN of confronting and wanting torture and inhuman and degrading treatment to come to an end. And I think that when the US behaves like this, when it treats people in its prison system in this way, it demeans itself in front of the rest of the world.
This is Herman Wallace, along with Albert Woodfox, out of solitary confinement here at Angola State Penitentiary. The Angola 3 reaches out to you from the belly of the beast. It is not that we have been held captive for over 35 years in prison, or that this is important. What is important is that we continue to hold high the principles of the Black Panther Party. Time has changed our bodies, but not our resolve, nor has it taken our strength. Gray hairs adorn our heads, but each grain is buried and cultivated by wisdom born of life's experiences.
Truth is truth, no matter what I think. Knowledge is power, but it ain't. If you can't occupy your own body and mind, see through the blind in this place full of lies. Television telling lies to your vision and face. Seems like more of us in prison than the workplace. Getting gadgets so it's easy to forget. Economics, no money, not a damn thing funny. Some dig every minute of it, I'm hating every second of it. Driven, ever since I heard the lie about Thanksgiving. While I'm still thankful through all that fibbing, the truth dies, while them lies make a living. History games, playing stealing family names, slave names turning to government names. Name of the game is to hide that game, and them lies living on with no shame. No lie, truth decay, brush up on your facts, and all you got to do is check them stats for what's in.